So this is the cover of Cancer Today. Look at that gorgeous face and smile on it. Loriana Hernandez-Adama, a former news anchor turned cancer survivor in Loudoun County. Loriana joins us now with more on her fierce battle with leukemia and how fitness helped her in her fight. This is special for us because Loriana and I used to work in Austin together at the same time. It's so great to see you.
It is great to see you. I got all choked up and emotional to be able to see you again.
No, great to see that you're doing so well.
Thank you. Well, it is a tough road, and there are some rough days and really rough spots for me and for everyone. But you know, when I was in Austin or throughout my 20-year career on TV, I was the health and wellness reporter as well.
This was your beat.
This was my beat. I was the health and wellness reporter, host of Clean Eating segment, telling you to eat this, not that. And then the irony of all ironies, I become the story, and I felt like I had to answer to viewers, and I had to put on my reporter hat and get some answers from doctors of saying, well, how does this happen to me? I thought I'd checked off everything to prevent it.
I remember your picture postings of kale chips and trying to get people in the newsroom to eat those. So tell me, you know, when this is now affecting you personally, where does the healthy eating we always knew? So where does the fitness component come into all
of this? So the doctor said, I brought the shirts and the logo because the doctor said, you're going to need to put your armor on. You're going to be separated from my then 2-year-old son for 1 year. And I fell to the floor and he said, but what matters is you may not always be able to prevent in life, but you can prepare. And don't be upset with yourself. You showed up so prepared. And the more fit you are, the more aggressive we can treat you, the bigger bag of chemo we can give you. Other patients, we have to tiptoe around their illness, whether it's diabetes, obesity, high blood pressure. And he said other people, and that's our biggest challenge besides finding a cure, is that we can't treat people with the dose they need to survive. Right. And we could boost numbers and help more people survive if they're fit. So I said, well, this is the, I get an ArmorUp, and people said, what can we send you? I said, send me fitness gear, fitness tracker, shoes.
Really?
So I can get fit and be my own hero, be the best version of myself and meet doctors halfway.
So you started, this is your nonprofit. It's called ArmorUp. This is where that name comes from.
Yes.
So did you do anything, because you are one, did you do anything different from what you were already, from what was normal for Lori? Like, did you do anything different as far as your eating, your exercise, or did you just simply ramp everything up
in order to take on this
huge endeavor?
I call it the trifecta. You need to show up fit. If it happens to you tomorrow, you need to stay fit. Okay. And you need to recover and be fit. And your hero, my sister, for the bone marrow transplant I needed, they tested her fitness level. And if she was not fit enough, she was not going to be able to save my life. So fitness plays a big role. And I ask everyone today, if you were diagnosed, how big a dose would you get? And if you have a child waiting at home, wouldn't you want to be in the best shape and be the best version of yourself?
We are almost out of time, but I want you to mention the Zumbathon.
Okay,
tell me about this.
We have partnered with US Fitness to help patients at GW Hospital and anybody else who wants to apply. We are having at 29 fitness locations, you can go into any US Fitness, One Life, Crunch, Sport and Health, and drop off new or gently used fitness gear. And we're going to outfit cancer patients all over the DMV. But we have 6 Zumbathons. Our first one is the kickoff tomorrow at Tyson's Plaza outside. And so get your groove on, get your sweat on, armor up. We'll have swag bags from Whole Foods, Athleta. So it's a lot of great reasons to come out.
So let's keep talking about this on social. Let me find you on Facebook and Twitter, and we'll promote
this
some
more. You gotta move.
Absolutely.
One day in bed will set you back 4 days in muscle strength.
It's great to see you.
Loriana Hernandez-Adama, great to have you with us.
Thank you.